With a servo motor, you don't just give it electricity and have it spin endlessly. You also need to give it a control signal, which says to which angle the drive shaft on the servo should rotate. Tell it to rotate to 180 degrees, it will. Tell it to rotate to 20 degrees and it'll go 160 degrees back the other way. Also, most servos don't rotate freely over 360 degrees like a normal motor. The simplest way to use a servo motor is to have it set to its minimum, median, and maximum values using code. Remember though, servo motors are not particularly powerful and won't be able to lift large loads. To connect a servo motor to your Raspberry Pi, find the three jumper wires extending from it. Different makes have different coloured wires, but you can be fairly safe in assuming that the 5-volt, or power wire, will be red, and you should connect that to pin 1. The ground wire will be black, or sometimes brown, and can be connected to any pin marked GND on your Raspberry Pi. The remaining wire will be your signal wire, which you can attach to any numbered pin. Just remember which pin you are using for your code, if you don't copy the diagram shown here. In this example, we have wired the servo to pin 17. Once you have wired your servo to the Raspberry Pi, you can test its working with this script.